Jesus was created by God the Father. Hello everyone. Recently I was having a conversation with a brother who came up to me and said that Jesus was created by God the Father. That too based on a scriptural passage from Colossians chapter 1 verse 15. It says, He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. This verse has created controversies in the history of the church, because several people have taken this verse like that of this brother, because this verse says he is the firstborn of all creation. People believe and people say that Jesus was created. Now if you look carefully into the history of the church, a person named Arius, who was a heretic teacher, also came up with the same kind of an understanding, and he said that Jesus was created by God and he was given the highest authority. And he also said that there was a time when Jesus was not. That means he says that Jesus did not exist from eternity. At some point of time, there was a beginning for Jesus. But if you look carefully into this text, does Paul really mean that? And even today, many people, like a group called Jehovah's Witnesses, have taken this verse in that terms. But when we look into this context, if you read that first part of that same verse, it says, He is the image of the invisible God. What is Paul trying to say when he says that he is the image of the invisible God? He says that Jesus is the manifestation and representation of God, and in every form he himself is God. That is what he's trying to explain when he says that he is the image of the invisible God, and following which he says the firstborn of all creation. And this part has created this controversy, and many people say that he was the first created being. But in order to understand this particular verse, you need to look carefully into the next verse. Verse 16, it says, For by him all things were created, in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through him and for him. So the next verse itself says that everything that was created by Jesus Christ. So if Jesus was created in verse 15, then verse 16 would stand as a contradictory verse to verse 15. Because Paul is not trying to explain and say that Jesus was created. He says that in verse 16, he created everything. In fact, one issue that was there in the church at Colossae was people denied the divinity of Christ. And that is where, in that context, Paul is trying to bring and say that no, he is completely divine. He is totally divine. That is what Paul is trying to explain in this letter. Now, when you look at this word firstborn is not to be understood in terms of first created, but rather here that word signifies he is of the highest rank. Or either you can take in terms of priority of time. So he was before everything. In fact, one of the rabbis, he said that the ancient rabbis used to use this term firstborn for Yahweh. They used to say that Yahweh is the firstborn of the world. So this is not the first time that this word is used when it refers to God. So Paul used that terminology here in order to explain that Jesus is above all. Jesus is supreme over everything. So that is what Paul is trying to explain here. So friends, let us not understand this verse in terms of how Arius understood or how today's Jehovah's Witnesses understand this verse. That is not how we are supposed to take this verse. This verse doesn't say that Jesus was created. This verse just means that he is the highest rank, or he is of the highest rank, supreme over everything. And he is the one who is behind this awesome creation. And let's worship him for who he is. Let's adore him for who he is. May God richly bless you through the meditation of this verse. Thank you.